Hi, I'm Josh, and today we're going to take a look at emus, emulators, game emulators for your computer. Basically, the better your computer is, the better your game is going to run. Also, if you have a good graphics card, or if you have a graphics card at all, make sure the drivers are up to date, you know, all that. So anyway, let's get started. First, let's go to emulator zone right here, and basically on the left you'll see a list of all the different game consoles that you can download an emulator for. Okay, so I think let's try a Nintendo 64. If you go down the list, it's in order of best rating to worst rating. Project 64 is the one I use. I used to use MuPen 64, a different version of it, so I could play online. You can actually play other people online if you know how to set up Kylera and fort porting and all that, but I'll say that for another time. Okay, so you go to Project 64's page. Okay, these are the requirements. Basically, you go to here and click download. Or you can Google for Project 64. So I already downloaded it. And yes. So now we will go to downloads, Project 64. And you'll install it. I'm not really going to. Whatever. I already have a copy of it installed, but yeah, just reinstall it. Okay, so basically, you're going to need some game ROMs. Game ROMs are basically the game files that are dumped from cartridges for N64 or ripped off of DVDs, CDs of game consoles that use discs. And so if you go, and keep in mind, it's not legal unless you own the game. I own my N64 games, and so the ROMs aren't, I don't know exactly how legal it is, but it's definitely more legal if you actually own the game, obviously. Okay, so you go to coolrom.com. And you can find all your favorite ROMs. Basically, like, say you want, go to ROM files, then you click on your game system. So we'll go to N64, Nintendo 64. Here's a list of the most popular, top downloaded. Awesome game right here, Super Smash. You can browse by letter. It actually has a link to the emulator for using the ROMs if you didn't already have it. Basically, you can search for whatever, like, say, Perfect Dark. Sorry, I'm typing with one holding the mic. So there you go. Perfect Dark, Game Boy Color, or Nintendo. So you may click the button to download your file. So wait until the timer counts down, click on download your file, and Project 64 finished. Awesome. So that's that. Now Perfect Dark is downloading. Luckily I have a fast internet speed. Okay, here's the setup page for Project 64, so hit OK. Okay, and now you have this nice, pretty little graphical user interface. GUI. And what you'll do is you'll go to choose ROM directory. So basically, you'll have to unzip the file, obviously. And let's do that really quick. I want to show you. Perfect Dark. It's a Z64 file. There's V64, there's Z64. I think there's also a ROM.ROM extension. I'm not sure if that's for N64 or not, though. But yeah, So yeah, you would extract it, obviously, and here you go, Perfect Dark. Okay, so basically once you've extracted all your games into your folder that you're going to keep them in, you'll go over here, open up Project 64, and go to choose ROM directory, and select your folder. And after you do that, they should all pop up like so, right in the window. We are going to open up Project 64. Okay, so now all your games are loaded. See all these games? It's so precious to me. They are so precious to me. That sounded really gay. Anyway. Smash Brothers. Let's try Smash Brothers. Okay. First things first. You can configure the plugins. Their settings. You can set these here if they're not working right for you. You can download more plugins into the plugin directory, which is in the program folder under program files. You can configure the graphics, how it works, basically, and as well as audio and the controller. This is the important one. Okay, usually it's on none, but if you could plug in a controller, like mine, right here, Xbox, basically, I'll show you what it is. I think I have the link open. Yeah, this I bought. It's called a 3-in-1 Magic Joy Box. You can Google that. You can find them like for as much as like $60. This one's $23. That's pretty cheap. So yeah, buy one of those or find a game controller. It doesn't matter what kind. That is powered through USB. And plugs in through USB. So you plug that in, and basically it should show up in here. And then once that happens, you can turn on the memory pack. You might have to turn on the memory pack for some games. Now, over here, you see all the controls. So I started setting them up. So like L, you hold down the L button, and then you click the button, and it sets it to Joypad 4. Now you hold down the R trigger, click. There you go. C button. So we'll do L, and you guys get the picture, okay? Basically, when you're done setting it up, go to Save Profile, and then you can name it so you'll know what you're talking about. So in my case, it's a GameCube controller. So you can save that into wherever you want. Me personally, I think I'll put it in my Project 64 controller profiles. Save it in there. Although that is a different version of the game. But anyway, you could navigate over to your programs folder, and there should be a folder in there for controller profiles as well. You could save it in. Or just save it to your My Documents. It doesn't really matter. Anyway, if the program loads up, controls aren't working, come in here. You may have to hit load profile, in which case you would load it, and then it brings up your settings again. Okay, so you could save one for GameCube, and then go to Player 2. If you have another controller plugged into it, you can have up to 3 at a time, plus a keyboard. So you can really have 4 people playing, or get the 3-in-1 and another game controller with USB. You'll have all 4. Basically, you just set each one accordingly. And save the profiles, make sure they're loaded properly, and bam, you got a 4-player game going on. So, yeah, let's resume. I'm on a laptop, so it kind of lags slightly. I feel like I'm running something. Oh, yeah, it doesn't run as fast when you're capturing the screen. That's probably most of my problem right there. It's processor intensive and memory intensive. So, yeah, basically, that's the tutorial. If you have any questions, let me know. Put them in the comments section. Thumbs up if you liked it. Yeah, I guess I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching.